If anyone is not seeing my screen, please let me know. I think I shared to everyone. Okay, just let me recap what we discussed in our previous classes. Yesterday we discussed about types of Oracle SQL commands, right? There are like DDL commands are there, and DML commands are there, DCL commands are there, okay, and DQL commands are there, TQL commands, TCL commands. So these are all the types of commands. And in DDL, we have like a create, order, drop, and in DML, insert, update, delete, and DCL, grant, revoke, okay. And TQL, that is select with various conditions, and TCL, that is commit, rollback, and save point. Okay. So the agenda for today's class is DDL commands. Okay. So in DDL, first we'll discuss about creating tables. This is a command. Okay, creating tables. So example. So we all know that syntax of the creating tables, right? Creating a simple database table. Simple database table. Okay. So let me explain the syntax first. When you connect to the SQL, Oracle SQL, you will see this prompt. Okay. So here, create table, table name. Create table, table name. Then open the bracket, column 1, data type, bracket, open width, comma. Then column 2. Okay. Column 1, column 2, data type of width. So if you have any constraints, column 3, data type of width, and will give constraint name also here. Data type of width and constraint name. But don't worry about the constraint name, we'll discuss about it going forward. Okay, this is the syntax. Okay, now example. Create a table to store address information like name, father's name. This is very simple table. Going forward, we'll create some complex tables also, but this is just very, very simple table. How to create the simple table with data types. Okay, so name, father's name, and to cover all the data types, just I'm giving gender, okay, and age. Okay, if he is working in any organization, what would be the data. Okay, so now this is our first step in Oracle SQL. I'm going to show you how to create the table. Okay, so once you get the credential for the system, you will have this SQL class on your desktop. Okay, you'll have SQL class on your desktop. You will be getting the remote desktop credentials. If you install the SQL in your system, finally you will see this SQL plus in your system. So when you double click here, the username password, you can right now currently you can do the username as apps, APPS, password also APPS, and host, this you have to give VIS. Okay, username is APPS, password also APPS, and host is VIS. In your project, in your company, the TPA will share you these details. Installation and everything will be taken care by the system administrator, and all the credentials will be shared by the TPAs. Okay, you don't need to worry about it, the credentials. As soon as you join, you are assigned to the project, they will provide you the credentials. Okay, in the system, the software will be ready, and just you need to connect and you start working. Does a username password and host is this, then click OK. So the SQL prompt is displayed here. Now I connected to Oracle SQL. Okay, I connected to Oracle SQL. Now, coming to the first step in DDL commands, that is create. Create, alter, and drop. We have three methods. So first we are talking about creating database tables. This is the syntax. Now let's create the table. So what we have to do is to create the table, this syntax we have to follow. Here at SQL prompt, you have to write the statement create table. Okay, create table. And what's in your table name? Okay, so that you have to give the table name. Okay. For example, address underscore TBL, something like that. You can give any name, okay? You can give any name. Just I'm saying address table here, but you can give any name. Okay. So then enter, open the bracket. Create table, table name, open the bracket. What is your first column? Name. Right? So we'll write name. What is the data type? We have four data types, right? Basically, what are the data types we have? Data types. One is char, second one is name char 2, third one is number, fourth one is date. The maximum width is for this is max 250, this is max 4000, this is up to 37 decimals you can give. Date is common, DDMYY. Okay, this is the default. The limit is, it's up to, you can give 31st December 12th, 31st 12th 9999, up to this date you can give. Okay, so these are the data types we are using. Now, for name, the new column that I am giving right here, name. For the name, you have to give the data type as name here. Or you can give some, for example, 20. So that means I am going to write the name with max of 20 characters. But you can give up to 4000. It doesn't matter. It's 20 minutes. You have to give 20. You can give up to 20. But if you want more, you can change like 30, 40, something like 20 characters. I am going to write names with 20 characters. Next one, father's name, there can two of again 30, comma. So just observe, for every column I'm giving comma. Father's name is there, then gender, care of one, because just I'm going to put like M R F. Okay, just see it later. If it is exactly, if you know this is the length, then you can go ahead with the care of one. Care of care. Okay, gender, then age, that is number. Only integers, no decimals in the age, right? But if you want to give decimals, suppose the age is 20 years, 5 months. So 20 years, 5 months means you can give something like this, 5, 2. How many decimals you are going to put? For example, 20.5. 20.5 means 20.5, so total 4. So 4, comma, how many decimals are there? 1 decimal. So like this you can give. Okay, but right now age will go only the integer. Going forward, when we create employee tables, purchase tables, invoice tables, etc., that time we will use the decimal places. Okay, so age number, then date of joining, date. Okay, close the bracket. For date, you have to simply give date. So name, the name I am going to write it as a character. That is why I am creating the table with the name as character type, and father's name is character, gender is character, that is only one letter, age is number, date of joining is date. After this, just simply press enter. So it shows table created. Okay. So this is the first table that we created in Oracle SQL. Okay. What is there inside this? It won't have anything, any information it won't have, because it's a new table, it's just empty table. Okay. Again, if you want to see the structure of this table, you can do description, or you can call it as describe address underscore tbl. Describe address tbl. Similar. So this is the structure. For this entire structure, the name is this. So address is address table is called table name, and the description is this. So we have nothing in this. If you want to see is there any data, by default system has created any records, then you can select start from address tbl. So no records because it's new, right? It's new record, new table. Now we wanted to load some information in that. I wanted to insert some records in that. Okay, I wanted to insert some data. Like father name XYZ, our name is XYZ, father name is ABC, something like that. Then what we have to do is, after creating a table, if you want to insert some information in the table, we have to write a command that is insert. Okay. Basically, the insert is DML command. It's a data manipulation. But at this point of time, that is required. Okay, so to insert the data will do. There are a lot of other things also there with insert, but right now what we want is, I have a table, but I want to load some data. So for that, I need to use the insert statement. So I'll explain how to insert the data first. Okay, so insert, we need to write insert into table. In which table you are inserting address? Address underscore table. What are the values? We have to do that. Just you need to remember this. Insert into address table values. Values means the data that you are going to insert. Okay. Values means the data that you are going to insert. Bracket open. Okay. What are the values? First name. Right. So you can give gates. Make sure the characters and the date should be between single characters, single quote. Okay, between single quote, because it's a character type. But for number, it's not required. Except number, for all data types, other data types like character, varchar, date, we need to enclose that value in single quotations. And make sure you are following the order. Okay, name, that's fine. Name I have meant. Next, what is the next column? Father's name, comma. So for example, Steven. This is father's name, comma. Gender, you can put something like M, male, comma. Age, say for example, 30, comma. Date of joining, again, this 30 is not in between single quotation. It's not required. The single quote is not required like this. Like this, it's not required because it's a number. So for numbers, we don't need. Okay, next date. The date is 10th, for example, January. 2017. Okay, close the bracket. It's simple. Insert into the table. Okay, which table you are inserting? Values we have to write. Then what are the values for? Again, it's these columns we have to give. We need to make sure the order. Here, four, total five columns, right? We have to give five values. The same order we have to follow. Okay, so created the table. Then we are inserting the records. Now I'll press enter. It is showing one row record, one row inserted. Before inserting, there was no data, right? Before inserting, there was no data. But now, you can, to see the data, okay, whether it is inserted or not, I wanted to see. To see the data, what you have to do? Select start from address table. Okay, you can see the data.
Ganesh. A quick question.
Yeah.
Okay, if I have to insert another name in this into this table, so is right. It after the semicolon I need to continue?
Okay, so not after the semicolon. If you want insert more records, okay, if you have only just two records, you have to write the insert statement again. Okay. So again, okay. We need to write insert into address table values. For example, Kumar is the name. Say Raj is the father's name, okay, and male, then 25 is age, so that's 10th October 2016 is that age. Okay, enter. So another record is inserted. Now again we have to write select star from address table. There are two records.
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, but yeah, I'm coming to your point. But it's very difficult to write the command again and again and again, right? If you have 10 records, so it's difficult to write 10 times, correct? So there is another way. Okay, I'm going to explain. You get that? Okay. Any questions, Sanjay?
No. If you can show that.
Yeah. Okay. So as of now, we discussed about how to create the simple table. This is the table, and how to see the structure again. Okay, this is the command description of the table, and to view the data, this is the query. The star is nothing but all columns. All columns means name, father's name, gender, age, etc. And since this is a new table, there are no records, but I inserted one record using the insert command, insert into the table values. So we have to give the values for each and every column. Then it shows one row created. Then again, to see the data, you can give the select star from sensor table. So like this, you can insert the records. Okay. So we created a simple table and we inserted two records. Now, I wanted to ask everyone, is this clear, or you have any questions? It is like you all followed me, or it is just I need to slow, or is that okay? Vijay, do you have any questions?
No, Gopal.
Okay, you're good. Teja? Okay. Sunita, any questions?
No, nothing from my side.
Okay. Suma?
Is the text very case sensitive?
No, it's not case sensitive.
Okay,
it's not case sensitive. Only the data, if you want to write it in the capital letters, you can write it in capital letters, or small, you can write it. But commands are not case sensitive. These are all the commands, right?
Yeah.
These are all commands, so the commands are not case sensitive.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Subhash? Srini?
No questions, Gopal. Thank you.
Perfect. Okay. Sanjay, I think you're clear. Right?
I'm good. Yeah.
Praveen, Josna. Okay, fine. So these notes will be shared to all your email IDs. Okay, so save, just you need to follow and you need to practice. Okay, so now let me copy this. Okay, from here, example, this is a command you need to write, just enter during your practice. It shows table created, then description, then select star from no row selected, insert the record, second record is inserted, total you are seeing two records. Okay, now to clear the screen, just you can type CLSCR. Okay, to clear the screen, you can write CLSCR. It will be clear. Again, you can go back and you can see select star from address table. Okay, so now there is an easiest way to insert more records. Okay, if you want to insert more records, this is the command you need to call. Insert into address table values. Instead of writing or hard coding the value, okay, instead of hard coding the value, what you have to do is in the single quotation, because it's a character type, what is the first column? Name, right? You can give name. comma, again ampersand father's name, and again ampersand what is that next column, gender, and age is a number, so you can give directly ampersand age and ampersand data type. The column names you can mention here, but we have to give ampersand. This is called address operator. What this address operator will, it will help you to insert the data at runtime. That's what it is basically. It will help you to insert at runtime. Instead of hard coding, at runtime you can give the value. Okay. So now let me run this command. Insert into address table values. Only I am not hard coding. Just what I am doing, I am just giving address and the column name. Address column, address operator, we'll call it as ampersand operator or input operator. Okay, and make sure for characters you give single quotation. All the character columns we have to give the single quotation. For number it's not required. Characters and date we have to give. So when you press enter, it will ask you like enter value of name. Okay, now I can give name here. Okay, father's name, gender, say for example male or female, whatever it is. Okay. So what was created, see, you observe, right, it is asking the values here at runtime. Now if I want another record, just what I need to do is, I no need to write the command again, simply I give slash enter. So I can give different name now. Okay, for example, so again you can give slash enter, you can give next value. Okay, right, so total 3 records inserted. Now I can go back and see the data. This is about how to insert. We created a table and we inserted a record.
So Ganesh, Ganesh, with the help of that ampersand, right, that which we give before the name, yeah. And okay, so is it because of that only we are able to insert unlimited data?
Correct. The what this ampersand will do is, when you press enter, it will ask you this enter value for name. What is the value for the name, father's name, gender, age, and date of birth. It is input, right? If you look at the first command, insert into, this is the command, right? We have written, right? As soon as you press enter, it is asking the name. What is the value for the name? What is the value for father's name? Enter the value for gender, and these values we entered, right? These values we entered, then it shows, okay, this is the command you have typed. And these are the values inserted against this. James is against name. This will be given by the system. Then it shows one row created. Then again, when I press slash, what this basically the slash will do is, it will run the command again. The same command will be executed. Then again, it is asking the ampersand name. That means enter value for name. The ampersand father's name. That is, what is the father's name value? What is the gender value? What is the age value? What is the date of joining value? Okay, it shows this. So like this, you can have number of records you can insert. Then finally, after that, again to see the data again, select star from address table. To save this, simply you have to give commit. So now the data is stored in the table. So tomorrow again you can come back and then you can connect to the RFS scale and you can see your data. So 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 this is how to create a simple table. This is the syntax we have to follow, and this is the example. And to insert more records using ampersand, okay, this is the statement that we have to create. So this is another example. So here.
Sorry, Gopal, I have a question here.
Yeah.
Now, you have used DML statement as SQL and TCL now. So if you use backslash, which one will be called now?
What is that? If you use?
You inserted data, you queried the data, now you committed the data.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
If you use the backslash, it is a repeat of the functionality. So which one will be called now?
No, backslash, okay. Backslash always, it's not a backslash, basically it's a slash, okay. Slash always excludes the previous command.
Just the previous command, okay.
Just previous command. The commit, right? Commit is the previous command, right? So that excludes.
So it does not discriminate whether it is DML or RTQL or
TCL. No, only the previous command.
Okay. Thanks, Gopal.
Yeah. Okay. So this is inserting records using ampersand. This is called address operator. Okay, and this is the example. So what this address operator will do is, this operator will help you to read values at runtime. And this is the example. Okay, next command. Now, sometimes you want to insert values for only specific columns. Okay, sometimes you want to insert values for specific columns, like I wanted to insert for name and age only. Not all the columns I want to insert, just name and age. So the command that you have to write is insert into table, address table, name and age, okay, values, change my name here, sorry, by mistake somebody entered here, okay. So insert into address table name comma age, because I'm okay, the requirement is what I wanted to insert name and age, right? Not all the columns. So what you need to do is insert into the table in the columns that you want. We need to specify values. Here we can give like ampersand name, comma, ampersand age. So it will ask name and age only. Okay. Say for example, Krishna 20 slash Anand 30, like this. So again, you can go back and you can see the data. Address table. See, Krishna and Anand is inserted with only age. So if you look at this command, insert into table, columns that you need to specify, this is very important. The same columns that we have in the table, you need to specify them. Then values, yes, you have to give those coordinates here. So that means I'm going to enter the name, I'm going to enter the age, those will be assigned to name and age. Say name, age, name Krishna, 30, name Anand, 30. If you want, just hard code it, you can hard code it also. Instead of using that ampersand, you can insert into address table of name comma age, values, some XYZ name, and 34 is the age, only that record is inserted. But if you give slash, right, what happens here? The same record will be inserted. It won't read, it will insert the same record again if you give the slash. But ampersand, when you use ampersand, again it will ask you that, okay, what is the next value, what is the next value? So what I'm trying to say is, like, if you are going to insert more and more records, then give some percent. Now just one or two records means you can type it, you can hard code it. That's all. So this is an example for inserting records for specific columns. There are a lot of other insert commands are there. We will discuss them in detail while working on insert command DML options. Okay. This is the command to insert values for specific columns. So these are all the examples. When you are practicing this, you can refer this so that it will be easy to understand and easy to practice. All the commands which are implemented, executed, and pasted here. So just you need to go step by step. That's it. That's what you need to do. From here, you have to start. Create simple database table. Okay. This is our first statement, first command. So this is the syntax, and this is the example. Okay. Created. This is the table, address table. Table is created. Then you can see the description. Then you can see the data, no records. Wherever SQL is there, that is the command. And we are inserting the data. Okay, it's created. And select star from table. Yes, we are seeing the data. Before insert, there is no data. Again, another record is inserted for all the values, all the columns. So total two records we have. This is the example for creating a table and insert records for all the values, all the columns. Okay, next, inserting records using operator, ampersand operator. This is a command, insert into address table values, ampersand operator. So it will ask you, okay, you need to enter these values here. Then after the last column, it will show this message, like one record created. You can repeat that by giving slash. Okay, again, you can enter the next record. Example, I have entered three records. Then, okay, three records we are seeing here. That's done. Next, to save it, commit. This is basically commit is to save. Next, if you want to insert records of specific columns, then this is the command. Insert into table of columns. If I want values for only name and age, then I can give here. Okay, so like this. If you want to hard code it, you can hard code. But if you want more records, you can use that ampersand address operator. Finally, you can see the data here. Okay. So one observation here, okay, one which that is very, very important for the next class. See here, either if you don't give the father name, it is accepted. If you don't give the age, or sorry, gender, it is accepted. That means the table is accepting even null records also, right? The table is accepting, it's not validating. The point that you need to observe is here, whatever you give, it is taken. Either you give. I request everyone on mute, please. Okay, thank you. So whatever we are giving, it is taking. Just it is not insert, it is not validating. Validating in the sense it is not checking whether it's a duplicate data, whether you are giving like right age. If you give age 99 also, it will accept. And if you are not giving any date, it is accepting. Okay, that means whatever you enter, it is taking. So it is not validating because it's very simple table. There are no constraints applied. Constraints appliments should not take duplicate records or validate the date, validate the age, check the name is entered or not. If the name is blank, don't insert. If the age is less than 18, don't insert. If the date of joining is greater than system date, that is greater than today's date or tomorrow's date, something like this, then don't insert. Those conditions we haven't given there. So that's the reason whatever you give, it will take. It's a simple table and with no validations. But in tomorrow's class, we are going to discuss how to create a table with constraints. That is very, very important. Okay. That what the constraints will give you is how to avoid duplicate records. How to like restrict when you enter the duplicate data. And how to enter conditionally, how to accept conditionally satisfied data. Something like, let's take one simple example. Age should be minimum 18, for example. So I can give that, okay, that condition. If I enter 18, less than 18, 17, 16, something like that, then the system should reject that record immediately. Similarly, date of joining, automatically the date of joining should be generated by the system. System has to generate. Now the date of joining is not generated by the system. It is given by the developer or user, but the system has to generate the date of joining. Because if the employee is joined today, whenever I enter here, that record has to be generated with the today's date, something like this. And if I forget to enter the name, it should reject the record. Without name, how the record is created? Okay. If I give the father name and age, it will accept now, right? For example, insert here, insert into address table of father's name comma age, then values, okay, Chendo 34. It's inserted. So it's not validating whether name is there or not. But from the business point, it is wrong, right? Without name, how can you give that? How can you fill the form? Correct? So that means it is accepted. Flexibility is there. Because with no constraints, we have created a table. It is very simple table. That is why it is taking everything. But in next class, we are going to discuss about how to apply constraints. So those are called integrity constraints. Integrity constraints means when you start creating the table, you can apply the constraints like not to allow the duplicate values, not to allow the null records, okay, and validate the value, some conditions, and generate the data automatically, something like this. Okay, I'll explain in details. Those constraints are called like not null, primary key, check, default, foreign key, etc. Okay. After you get the knowledge, we are good to start RDB-based concept, like one-to-one table, one-to-many table, many-to-many tables, etc. Okay, but these are the basics, very, very important. It looks like simple, but it's very, very important. So I request everyone to practice, create tables again and again, more and more tables you create and insert the data. Okay, you should remember all the commands. That's very important. How to create a table means, okay, this is the command we have to get, create tables and so open the brackets and column 1, column 2, column 3, close the bracket. If I wanted to insert into table values, then values. So the practice is very, 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 very important. So that's what I request everyone to practice more and more. Okay. So yeah, that's all from my side. Today we discussed DDL commands. In this DDL, we discussed about how to create a simple table. There are a lot of other commands we are going to discuss in the next class.
Ganesh, if you go back to see after SQL, I don't know what, how, what do you say that SQL and a greater than sign?
Yeah, that's SQL prompt.
Okay, SQL prompt. Okay, if I have given a slash and it has asked me, you know, you enter the father name, which I don't want. So how do I remove that line?
Okay, yeah, that we are going to discuss all those commands, like in the DML commands, we have delete, right? Using this delete, we can remove the record. For example, now I enter XYZ, right? So I can write like delete from table called address, table where name equal. Okay, name equal. No, then that record will be there. Excel is not there. So if I want to remove where the name Chandu, so delete from address table. This is just to clear your doubt, but we are going to discuss about these commands in detail. Where father's name equals Chandu. So it's deleted.
Yeah, thank you. thank you. Thank you.
Ganesh, I have one doubt.
Okay.
While writing the syntax or the command, so address underscore table, so what does that underscore mean? Why we are giving that underscore?
Okay, this is just to identify whether it is a table or any other type of object, but it is not valid.
So usually we create tables only, no? Is there any other things which we
create. Yeah, we create tables. This is an example of the tables. Okay? Going forward, we are going to create views, okay, indexes, sequences, etc. Okay. So that time, if you are creating a view, then we'll give underscore V. If you are creating a sequence, we'll give underscore S or SCP. If you are creating index, we are going to give IDX, something like that.
Okay.
That is one just to, by seeing that, you can easily understand, okay, this is the table.
Okay. So like first, we need to know the syntax first. Later on, we can give all the table creation and all.
Right. Yeah, this is very, very important.
Okay.
Create
and how can mm-hmm. Okay. How can we download this Oracle SQL?
So ERPTREE will provide you the remote desktop details. Okay. So okay. What you need to do is just you need to from the start button right click on run.
Okay.
MST SC. Click okay. It will ask you the IP address. The IP address will be shared by ERPTREE.
Okay.
And login credentials. Okay.
Okay.
There are instructions. There is a document attachment will be there in your email. So
okay.
After you give the username and password, okay, it shows like this. This particular screen will be open.
Okay.
So just double click on SQL plus and give the username as APPS and VAS.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to put this how to connect to the remote desktop also here, so that helps to everyone. Connecting to the remote desktop. Okay. So what you have to do is start, then go to start run. Type MST SC. Then it will ask the IP address. So give the IP address there, then username, that username we have to give, and the password. Okay, so remote desktop will be open. Now double click on SQL plus. Okay, there username again, it will ask apps, password, apps, host it will ask as, like we have to give as VAS. Then SQL prompt will be open. From here, it will start writing commands. So this is clear to everyone?
Yeah, it's clear to me.
Yes.
IP address, username, password will be provided. And once you give those credentials, it will show you the remote desktop. Okay, this remote desktop will be open. Simply you need to double click on the SQL plus. Okay, so when you double click on SQL plus, it will ask you the username. You need to give the username as apps, password as apps, and host as VAS. Okay, so to start immediately, this is a better way. But later I will provide you the document which you can install in your system also, but that is time taking process. So when you get some time in the weekends or your leisure time, you can just focus on that. But to start immediately, this is recommended. Okay, so everything is there, just simply you need to log in and start working on the SQL part. That's it. Okay, I'm done for today. Any questions?
Ganesh, how do we exit from the SQL? Is it just exit?
That's a great question actually. Simply have to go. Okay, just before you exit, just give a comment and simply you type exit.
Okay.
That's it. Yeah.
Thank you.
Jyotsna. Lohita, Praveen, Jyotsna, any questions?
No, Ganesh, thanks.
Okay, Lohita? Okay, Praveen? Srini? Suma? Okay, perfect, okay. Suma, Sunita.
Yeah, Ganesh, I haven't received any notes or recording.
Share all those information. Okay.
Sorry?
Yeah, Raviteja, like whoever is contacted from the ERP driver, right? They will share you.
Okay.
So who is coordinating with you from ERP side, ERP side? Raviteja.
Sunil.
Okay. Yeah, I think Sunil will take care of it today. I think by end of the day today, I think you are going to receive all those details.
Tables in the SQL Plus with the ERP.
Okay.
Do you have any seeded tables in the SQL Plus?
Yes. We have seeded tables. Like there are seeded table called EMP and DEP. There are two tables, DEP and EMP.
So employee and the department.
Correct.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, we are going to execute them. We are going to execute the commands using those tables also.
Okay, that's great.
Apart from our tables, apart from the tables which we discussed, right? RDBA response, like purchase, invoice, supplier. That's our own database that we are going to design, because in every project we are going to design our own databases, own tables. Apart from that,
so
we are going to use that seeded tables, like department and DEP.
So Ganesh, can we connect those what we have worked on the system, you know, on the financial side, you know, onto the tables? Like, can I query, using the SQL Plus from here to, you know, to the database? Is that possible?
Yeah.
Like, whatever I have created.
Yes, it's possible.
Okay, great.
For example, now address table you created, right? So you can see that address table in your Oracle applications.
Yeah.
That's not your question, right? That's Oracle applications which you are using, right?
Yeah, we have employees, we have the supplier vendor information.
They're similar to the supplier form or like an invoice form. We have to create one form. Using the form builder, we will create one form. The form will be linked with your table, okay? And after that form is created, it will be attached to the responsibility. Any responsibility, if you are using like accounts payables responsibility or HRMS responsibility, we'll link that form to the responsibility and we'll connect to that responsibility, and when you double click on that employee form, it will show you the employee data.
Yeah, that looks
so cool. For that, you should know, all right, I have technical.
So is that very complicated process or is something simplified?
No, it's not complicated. But you should know Oracle applications technical parts like RISE components, reports, interfaces, conversions, etc. Here is a functional side, right? If you're not technical part, yeah, it will be easy. But the technical part you cannot learn directly. You should know this SQL and PLC first.
Right. I think probably a lot of work.
Yeah, prerequisite is SQL PLC. For anything, if you are strong with SQL and PLC, you can do anything from the technical side.
Yeah, it's almost like data mining, you know, you can just as much, you know, you can get, you know, as much information you want from, you know, whatever you have created.
Right.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, no problem. No questions, then okay, I can wind up the session. We'll meet tomorrow at the same time. Okay. Thank you all. Thanks for your time. Take care. Bye-bye.
Okay.